Hello students, myself Amrita Dhar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Engineering Department of Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, JIS Group. I will teach you Power System 3. Module 1 contains power system in restructured environment, distributed and dispersed generation, and environment aspects of electric power generation. Now, today we will discuss about power systems in restructured environment. This is our first lecture on this subject, Power System 3. At first, you have to understand what does regulation mean. The regulation are generally imposed by the government or the government authority. Now, this essentially represents a set of rules or framework that the government has imposed so as to run the system smoothly and with discipline without undue advantages to any particular entity at the cost of the end consumer. So, what is regulated industry? In any area, there was only one company or government agency, mostly state-owned, that produced, transmitted, distributed and sold the electric power and services. Now, for over 100 years, the electric power industry worldwide operated as regulated industry. Next one, traditional power utility. Now the traditional power system is in vertical in nature. Okay. Now, power system structure traditionally have been what are known as vertical integrated utilities. In this type of structure, one utility handles all the function of generation, transmission, distribution within a certain geographical area. The operation and the coordination of such system is somewhat simple. Since all functions are controllable by a system operator, the objectives were to provide quality to the customer while ensuring the reliability and overall economy. Overall economy means low cost. Now, the price of power was regulated and based on the actual cost. Now, next, the characteristics of traditional power industry. These are the characteristics. First one, monopoly franchise. Next, obligation to serve. Regulatory oversight, regulated rates, guaranteed rate of return, least cost operation. We will discuss one by one. So, first is monopoly franchise. Only the national or local electric utility was permitted to produce, transmitted, distributed and sell the commercial electric power within its service territory. Next, obligation to serve. The utility had to provide electricity for the needs of all consumers in its service area, not just those that were profitable. Next, regulatory oversight. The utility's business and operating practices had to conform to guidelines and rules set down by the government regulators. Fourth one, regulated rates. The electric utilities rate were either set or regulated in accordance with the government regulatory rules and guidelines. Fifth one, guaranteed rate of return. Obviously, the government guaranteed that regulated rules would provide the electric utility with a reasonable or fair profit margin above its cost. Last one, least cost operation. Now, the electric utility was required to operate in a manner that minimized overall revenue requires. Now, however, vertically integrated monopolies could not provide service as efficiently as competitive firms such as in airlines, telephone and natural and gas industries. The electric power industry plans to improve its efficiency by providing a more reliable energy at least cost to customers through restructuring. Next one, need for restructuring. Now, vertically integrated monopolies could not provide service as efficiently as competitive firms like airline, telephone, natural gas industries, the electric power industry plans to improve its efficiency by providing a more reliable energy at least cost to customer through restructuring. Now, competition is guaranteed by establishing a restructured environment in which customers could choose to buy from different suppliers and change the suppliers as they wish in order to pay market-based rates. Now, by competition, the customer will benefit. Suppose you want to buy a mobile phone. You have option. You can buy Samsung, Nokia, Vivo, Oppo, LG. There are lots of options. Or suppose you want to buy a cold drink. You have options between. You have lots of options in this category also. Can buy Coca-Cola, or Pepsi, or Thumbs Up, or Fanta, or Limca according to your taste. Now, by competition, customer will always get the benefits. So, what are the reasons for restructuring? Now, the first one is the fundamental reason. Now, more fundamental than any other reason for change was the fact that the basic needs for regulation of electric industry had died away before the end of 20th century. Now, first, original need for regulation, which was to provide risk-free finance to build the infrastructure, and did not exist anymore. And second, the most of the major electric infrastructure was paid for decades ago. The revenues gained by the electric utilities was invested to renew their system, and the level of risk is doing so was less as compared to that existed in the initial era. Now, being a proof technology, the risk involved in investing money in such a technology was nullified. The electricity could now be thought of as an essential commodity and which can be bought and sold in the marketplace in a competitive manner just like other commodities. Okay, so this is the fundamental reason. Next, ideological reason. Now, privatization, usually the motive was the government's firm conviction that the private industry could do a better job of running the power industry. This belief, of course, came from better privatization experience of all the other industry. Now, deregulation does not necessarily have to be a part of privatization effort. Third one, cost. Cost is expected to drop. Now, competition is expected to bring innovation, efficiency. Now, cost is expected to drop. Now, if there is a competitive market, the cost will obviously decrease. Now, the competition is also to bring the innovation, efficiency, and which I just said, lower cost. Fourth one is the customer focus will improve. Now, although the monopoly franchise utilities have an obligation to serve all customers, that does not promote to proactive attention to customer needs. A monopoly franchise utilities listen to its customer when they explain their needs and then responds. But a competitive electric service company anticipates customers' needs and responds in advance. The technology advances that will be applied under deregulation addresses customer service. Now, more important gain of competition in the electricity market is the customer value rather than lowering the cost. Now you all know that that competition really improves the customer service. Now take an example of airline and railway. Now in airline you have lots of options. So they greet their customer with the smiling face. But in railway there is a monopoly market. So you don't expect such greetings from the railway department. Fifth one is the encouragement for innovation. Now competition always encourages the innovation. The regulatory process and the lack of competition gave electric utilities no incentive to prove on yesterday's performance or to take risk on the new ideas that might increase the customer value. To encourage competition, yes, of course, restructuring encourage the competition. So next one, deregulation. Now deregulation as a concept came in early 1990s. It brought in changes designed to encourage the competition. Electric deregulation is a process of changing rules and regulation that control the electric industry to provide customers the choice of electricity suppliers who are either retailers or traders by allowing the competition. Deregulation improves the economy efficiency of the production and use of electricity. Now, due to competition in the electric industry, the power prices are likely to come down, which benefits the customer. The main objectives of the deregulated markets are to provide electricity for all at for all reasonable demands. Now the main objectives of deregulated market, power market, are to provide electricity for all reasonable demands, to encourage the competition in the generation and supply of electricity, to improve the continuity of supply and the quality of service, to promote efficiency and economy of the power system. So, different entities in a deregulated environment. Now, what they have done? They divided the generation companies separated to GenCos, transmission companies separated to TransCos, distribution companies separated to DISCOs. And there are another services, that is retail energy service companies known as RESCOs, independent system operator ISO, and obviously the customer. So these are the different entities in a deregulated environment. Structure of deregulated system. Now in this structure, the energy is flowing from generation to transmission and distribution network, and from transmission and distribution network to the customer. So this is the same as the traditional system, but there is another two sectors, ISO, independent system operator, and retailer. Now the information is exchanged between generation and ISO, generation and transmission and distribution of network, and ISO with retailer. And the money is flowing from customer to retailer, customer to transmission and distribution network, generation to transmission and distribution network, retailer to the generation network. And money is also exchanged between ISO and generation, transmission distribution network, and ISO. Next, difference between regulated and deregulated system. Now the traditional regulated system is in vertical in nature, and deregulated system is in horizontal in nature. That's why restructuring. Now previously it is used to be a vertical structure, now it is a horizontal structure. Now in this figure you can see the four major components: generation, transmission and distribution network, and the customer. But here there are other two operators: independent system operator and retailer. Now in this figure you can see that money is flowing from customer to the electric supply, and information is only exchanged between generation and transmission and distribution network. That means within the electric company, within one company. But in this structure, the information is also exchanged between the customer with the retailer, retailer with the ISO, retailer with the generation, and ISO with the generation. Now this is common in both case. The energy flow in both case are same. Now here the energy is flowing from generation to transmission and distribution network, and from here it is delivered to the customer. Energy flow is same for both configuration. In both figure the energy is flowing from to generation to transmission distribution to customer. Here the flow of money is unidirectional, and it's only flowing from customer to the electric supply company. But here the money is flowing from customer to retailer, customer to transmission and distribution network, retailer to generation. The money is exchanged between ISO and generation. Money is flowing from generation to transmission and distribution network, and also money is exchanged between ISO with transmission and distribution network. Now some important terms. First one is open access. Now open access is the non-discriminatory provision for the use of transmission lines or distribution system or associated facility with such lines or system by any license or consumer or a person engaged in generation in accordance with the regulation specified by the appropriate commission. It will promote competition and in return lead to availability of cheaper power. Next one is wheeling. Wheeling is the operation whereby the distribution system and associated facilities of a transmission and distribution license are used by another person for the conveyance of electricity on payment of charges to be determined by the appropriate commission. Next one is the energy banking. Energy banking is a process under which the captive power plant or a co-generator supplies power to the grid, not with the intention of selling it to either a third party or to a licensee, but with the intention of exercising his eligibility to draw back this power from the grid at a prescribed time during next financial year, after deduction a banking charges. Last one is the unbundling or corporatization. Many state electricity boards have either been unbundled or corporatized. Distribution business is privatized in some states such as Delhi and Orissa. Next one is the employment of reforms. Now the earliest reforms in power industry are initiated by Chile, then they were followed by England and USA. Now in case of India, the reforms were initiated by Orissa, then followed by Haryana, and then followed by Andhra Pradesh. That's all from today's class. If you have any problem, please contact with me. My contact details is given on the first slide. Thank you.